Let's look at how to use Adobe InDesign and Data Merge to create a yearbook page or some other type of ad that has a grid of photos and some type of text such as names and titles. This is the document setup. I just have a letter size with an 1/8 inch bleed. And going to my master page, I have a name and title text box styled, and I'm going to recreate this image frame just so you can see. I know that my image frame is going to be a width of 2 inches by 2.875. Make sure that the lined. Just as an addition, let's go ahead and make rounded corners on this, which is kind of a nice addition. Okay, now that we have our master set up, let's go ahead and apply the master to our first page. Let's open up Excel, and this is the data we're going to dynamically input into this page. So I have a column for names, another column for titles, and the last column is slightly different. It's for images. For the image header cell, you need to do an apostrophe, @, and image. So these are all relative links. I don't want these specific to my computer. So if I were to package the InDesign file and keep the images with it, I want them to be linked and I want the path to be relative. So that starts with the forward slash. And if we look at my setup, I have the images in a folder called images. So this is the directory path. And so you'll just name them to the names of your images, whether they're people or something else. Now we're going to make sure this is saved as a CSV. So file format, CSV. And back in InDesign, we're going to go to Window, Utilities, Data Merge, and this gives some instruction. We're going to go to the flyout menu and select Data Source, select the CSV, and it's populated the columns with their titles of what we're going to use. Double click on your page. And you won't be able to select the text boxes now, so you're going to need to hold Command Shift or Control Shift on a PC. Double click and delete your text placeholder and drag and drop the value that you're going to want to fill. And do the same for the image. We can preview this, and you can go back and forth using this arrow pagination. So now let's look at how to make this a grid format. Go back to the flyout and go create merge document. We're going to want all records, and we're going to do multiple records on a page. Let's go ahead and do a preview and zoom out a little bit. Now if we go to multiple record layout, we can adjust the margins on the page. And you can also adjust between the columns and the rows. And for image options, you can also select how you want the images. I had sized all of these to fit or to be the exact dimensions, but you may want these to fit, you know, in a different placement. So select what you need. I want to link my images so they're not embedded. And let's go ahead and click OK. And it's letting us know that the text from our Excel sheet all fit within the text boxes we had. So this is a preview. It's created two pages. Or we could have adjusted our margins to make sure all of them fit on the same page. It, as you can see, the data merge opened a new document. So we still have our original if we need to recreate this.